There are a lot of things that make cruising a little bit different than other types of vacations, and one of those things are cruise line gratuities. In this video, I'm going to share with you everything that you need to know about who to tip on a cruise and exactly how that works. Hi there, I'm Ilana from the website LifeWellCruise.com. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Now, if you've been around the cruise community a little while, even if you booked a cruise recently, you have probably noticed that not only is tipping and gratuities a little bit confusing on a cruise, but it also is a bit of a controversial subject. But we are going to go through all of the information that you really need to know, including even some of the changes. Well, if you've cruised like a few years ago, some of the things that have changed even from that point. Now, this video is much requested, and I do think that I'll be going into all of the questions that you may have. Now, at the end of this video, I do have a question for you. So make sure that you do stay to the end. I do want to hear your thoughts on this. Now, I have a little favor to ask you. If you find this video helpful, informative, or enjoyable in any way, then please do give the video a big thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And of course, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so let's start off with talking about the basics so that you know what to expect about cruise line gratuities. So on most major cruise lines, you're going to be charged an automatic daily gratuity per person on your cruise. So the majority of cruise lines, this includes Royal Caribbean, Carnival, Holland America, most cruise lines are going to charge you about $14 to $15 US per person per day, and they're going to charge that to your onboard daily account. Now, these gratuities or tips are basically charged to your account, the cruise lines say, for your convenience. And the idea of this is this amount gets split among the different people that help you or serve you on your cruise, mainly your cabin attendant, your waiters, and the other dining staff. Now, more recently, some of the cruise lines have said that some of the tips do go to people who work sort of in the back of the house in support of your service. Now, I did say most major cruise lines because there are some cruise lines that don't charge you an additional tip or an additional gratuity, which I will talk about later in this video. Now, as for the question, should you remove gratuities on the cruise? I'm going to give you my personal opinion towards the end of this video, and I'd like to hear from you too, in a nice way, of course. Now, something that does have to be said is that cruise lines do pay a lower wage to the service staff. And the idea of this is that they understand that their tips will really make up a good portion of their wage, and that really is what they rely on. Now, some people will say this is wrong. That's something that we can debate at the end of this video. However, I always think of it a little bit like when you go to a restaurant, like, and I'm talking about specifically in North America, so maybe in the United States and in Canada, we usually do have something where restaurant staff that are working up front, they usually do get paid lower than even like the minimum wage of somebody who's working retail. And the understanding is they are getting tips that make up a good portion of their salary. And as a matter of fact, where I live, people that do work in restaurants that do work for tips like serving staff actually get taxed on an assumption that they're making tips. So I always think of it that way. Now, if you don't like the idea of seeing a daily charge on your account accrue, personally, I don't really love to see that. What you can do is you can prepay your gratuities before your cruise. Now, some people say they don't like to do that because they don't like to tip before they get the service. But I have to say, over recent years, I've done that and I've not found the service to not be good at all. I think the crew just do an amazing job, and across the board, we've had really very good service, even though we've prepaid our gratuities before our cruise. Now, if you've ever prepaid your gratuities, please let me know in the comments below if you've ever felt that this has affected the service on board. Now, while the automatic gratuities do go to your dining staff and your cabin attendant, there may be some other people that you might want to tip on a cruise. And I like to have some extra small dollar bills for these occasions. So starting with when you get to your cruise terminal, you have the luggage porters. It is customary to tip the luggage porters. Now, some people say they tip between $1 and $5 per bag. So that obviously is completely up to you, but have a few dollars that are rolled up ready to be able to give to the porter when you do arrive at the cruise terminal. Now, other people to tip on the cruise ship itself is anybody who's delivering your room service. Usually you'll get a little sort of receipt or a little bill, even if room service is included, and it will leave room for a tip. So you may want to leave an extra dollar or so. Now, when you go to a specialty restaurant, do check if there's a service charge that is charged. Some cruise lines will charge a service charge, but other cruise lines will not. If you don't have a service charge charged, make sure that you do tip these waiters. The service will be absolutely incredible. It's going to be one of the best meals that you've ever had in your life. So make sure that you do tip. Usually customary is 15, 18, or 20%. Now, when you do go on a shore excursion, something really nice to do is to tip your driver, to tip maybe your shore excursion guides. And of course, if you go to a restaurant or a bar when you're in port, make sure that you do tip them as well. Now, when you're on the ship, you may want to tip your favorite bartenders, but something that I will mention is when you do buy a drink, like any drink on the cruise, even if you have a beverage package, sometimes you'll get a little bill. You will see that at the bar, they are already charging a service charge. And typically it's about 18%. Some cruise lines even charge 20%. So you don't really need to tip over and above. But if you do have a bartender that's being particularly attentive and you do want to give them some extra money, I've heard of some people saying that they like to give a 20 or so to a favorite bartender, either early in the cruise or later in the cruise, or tipping an extra dollar per drink. If you just want a ballpark figure as to how much to budget for your gratuities, consider that if it's $14 to $15 US per day, per person, a couple would be paying about $30 a day. So for a 7-day cruise, you should budget probably about $200 for the couple. Now, if you are cruising with kids, most cruise lines will charge a gratuity for the children, but there are some cruise lines who won't charge a gratuity or maybe will have a reduced gratuity for children that are under the age of 4. Now, as I mentioned earlier in the video, cruise gratuities is just always a little bit of a contentious and even controversial issue. And some people really have said, why don't the cruise lines just include gratuities in the price of the cruise? Now, in the past, this was always kind of included on a lot of the luxury cruise lines. Cruise lines like Seabourn, Regent Seven Seas, Crystal Cruises, they all include the gratuities on your cruise. So unless you're booking a Simply Sail rate, you'll notice that Celebrity has your gratuities included. So this does mean a higher price point at the beginning, but there's a lot of things included, including the gratuities. Now, if you're sailing with Princess, while gratuities are not included on Princess, if you do opt for the Princess Plus pricing program, then you have the gratuities, or as they like to call them now, the crew incentive included as well. And if I'm not mistaken, I believe that Virgin Voyages completely knew that they include their gratuities as well. Now, if you are wondering how much the tips are on your specific cruise line, I do have a blog post all about this, and it outlines really the gratuities cruise line by cruise line, including some of the cruise lines where the gratuities are included. So I have all of that in a blog post. I will leave it in the description below. Now, you might be wondering if these cruise gratuities are mandatory or if you can opt out of the cruise gratuities and just basically tip the people that you want on your cruise. Now, most cruise lines will allow you to do so because gratuities are customary, but they're not technically mandatory. Now, if you do want to do this, you can ask to have the gratuities either removed or made higher or made lower. That really is your choice on the majority of cruise lines. Now, one cruise line that is an exception out of the more popular cruise lines is Norwegian Cruise Line. That is because rather than charging you cruise line gratuities, they will charge you a service fee per day. And because it's a service fee, well, it really is, they point out this is something that everybody pays. If you do have a problem with the service, if you have an issue, they ask that instead you go to guest services, you explain the issue, and they will work to solve this for you. Now, at the same time, I am going to give you a little bit of an opinion on this. You tell me your opinion in the comments below. Let's be nice. But personally, I don't think you should remove the gratuities. The crew work so hard. So this leads me to this question, and I'd love to know your thoughts, please, in the comments below. Now, a lot of people, I've seen comments that they've said, we would like to see gratuities included in the cost of the cruise. But something to remember is then the price is going to be higher. And some people have said that they feel a little bit of a pressure to still tip over and above that amount. So there's two things. One of them is, do you tip over and above the amount that the cruise line suggests, those automatic daily gratuities? There's no right or wrong answer here, but if you do feel comfortable, please leave that information in the comments below. And secondly, would you be in favor of cruise lines including the cost of the gratuities in their cruise fare. If you have any other questions about tipping on a cruise, please leave those questions in the comments below. Now, I'm gonna leave a video right after this one all about what you need to know about packing for a cruise. That's definitely a must watch. Now, I hope that you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And of course, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. Bye for now, and happy cruising.